the lineup for the Olympic final in the women's 200 butterfly. Zhang is in pole position and she's the favorite. Hallie Flickinger, the American, one of two Americans in this final. Flickinger in four, Smith in five. Sorry, Flickinger in five, Smith in six.
Well, very fast world record of 201.81, held by China, and the Olympic record held by China as well. Here's Alice Thomas from Great Britain, taking lane number eight in this final, gold medalist at the Commonwealth Games.
In one for the Russian Olympic Committee, the 25-year-old Svetlana Chimrova, seventh of the World Championships, bronze of the Europeans.
Representing Australia, Brianna Throssell. This is her second Olympic Games, second final. She made it in 2016 as well. She raced the 4x200 freestyle heats for Australia.
In two for China, Yu Yan, sixth in the Asian Games. The 23-year-old is taking a big step forward in her career into this final of the women's 200 butterfly.
He's the 200 metres backstroke world champion, swimming across into butterfly. She raced the 100 here, won a bronze medal, 100 backstroke, and now Regan Smith is in the final of the 200 butterfly.
In three, the Hungarian, the world champion, Boglaka Kapas, fourth in Rio.
Hallie Flickinger is in lane number five, world ranked number one, the Pan Pac champion. She's a three-time national champion for America. Second Olympic Games.
And in lane four, the favourite, Zhang Yufei, gold medal in the 100 butterfly already. The favourite for gold in the two, the Asian Games champion. She finished sixth in Rio, fifth in the World Championships in 2019. The favourite for gold at these Olympic Games.
She goes out fast. 58 at the 100 in the semis. So there'll be an early turn of speed if she swims it the same way.
Well, it's interesting with the Americans. We've got Smith, the backstroke specialist, Flickinger, the bronze medal winner in the 400 individual medley here. All meeting in the 200 butterfly against the fly specialist Zhang Yufei. It's a fairly common double, 400 medley, 200 fly. We get ready then for the Olympic final in the women's 200 butterfly. Tense at the start. A look at the underwaters of Zhang Yufei, 23-year-old Chinese swimmer in four, already beginning to pull away from the field. We said she was going to go out quickly, and watch this.
Well, it's almost like she's sprinting the first 50 metres of a 200 metres butterfly. And from what we've seen, it is something that she can do for all four of the laps. She does start to fatigue a little bit, but she sets herself up beautifully under world record pace and great discipline underneath the water.
Watch the speed of hands under the water there. Great shot from the underwater camera. And this is what's making the difference. See the acceleration of the hands past the hips.
There's that world record line as we approach the halfway mark of this 200 metres butterfly final.
Well, this would be a stunning swim if Zhang can get down to a 201.8, the world record. No one's really expecting her to get down there, perhaps, except her. Zhang on her own, leading them through the midpoint as the Americans following close attention, Flickinger and Smith.
Off the world record pace now, it's about racing this and winning a gold medal. And Flickinger is trying desperately to catch, but look at this gap. She's gone out fast, Zhang. She's gone out in 58.29, starting to slow down, starting to shorten up a little bit, but the gap is big.
Well, that's a terrifically committed swim from Zhang, and the field are going to come back on her. This is going to give momentum to Flickinger and Smith. They know they're catching. The question is, has Zhang gone too fast, too early?
Well, Flickinger was 0.2 of a second slower in that lap. I'm not sure she can get her. I think Zhang might have done enough.
In the closing stages then, it's Zhang on course for double gold. The battle between the Americans for the minor medals as Karpass tries her best up in lane three. Smith in six, closer to us, just takes silver. Flickinger with the bronze, and somehow the Americans have found their way to the medal once again in second and third as all smiles, celebrations for Zhang. She's won gold in the 100, gold in the 200, drifting out to 203.86. But there's more to come from this 23-year-old Chinese swimmer. If she can just measure her effort a little bit more closely up the first 50, come back on the charge, the world record might be under threat.
Regan Smith has just realised she's done a personal best time by over a second to get the silver medal. Zhang takes gold. She just sprinted in that first 50 metres. Great technique. Look at the power in the shoulders as the arms come across. The head bows back down. Staying very flat on the water. And she picked it back up in the final stages. I thought that she started to fatigue coming into the third 50. Full stroke on the touch. And the gap was 1.44 seconds between first and second. With a 203.86. And that's also her personal best time by over a second. From backstroke to butterfly. Well done, Regan Smith.
So wonderful pictures from the aquatics arena. And there's smiles, there's drama, there's surprise, celebration. This is what it means to compete at the highest level at the Olympic Games. The Olympic gold medal then going to Zhang Yufei for the second time. It's an Olympic record, 203.86, with Smith and Flickinger in silver and bronze.
One of the biggest winning margins in 200 butterfly history at the Olympic Games. The other two recorded were from the Madam Butterflies, Mary T. Maher and Susie O'Neill. Mary T. won the 84 games by 3.6 seconds. Susie O'Neill won 1996 by 2 seconds, and the winning margin these Olympic Games, 1.
This is double gold then for Zhang. She won gold in the 100 fly. Here she comes to receive a second gold medal in this, the 200 fly, and she was the favourite. There was no doubt about where victory was going to go as soon as Zhang hit the water. Minor medals going to the Americans, Smith and Flickinger. Sorry, my mistake. It isn't a double. My apologies to Maggie McNeil, who won the 100 fly.
Zhang was the silver medalist in a very close final in that 100 butterfly.
The medals will be presented by IOC member Costa Rica.
The medal presenters being introduced. It's a great performance in this 200 butterfly by Zhang.
So bronze for the Americans. This is Hallie Flickinger. Second bronze medal to her. She picked up bronze in the 400 individual medley. And now bronze in the 200 butterfly.
Greg Meehan is her coach, along with Bob Bowman. She's been studying finance, where she's graduated at University of Georgia, so college career as a Bulldog. Second Olympic Games. And training down in Arizona with the Sun Devils and Bob Bowman.
Silver medal.
second medal going to the United States in this, and this is Regan Smith, world record holder of the 200 backstroke. And silver medal in the 200 butterfly. That's a rare combination.
It is, it's a brave combination. Been really a standout junior swimmer that has converted beautifully into seeing a competition in both backstroke and butterfly.
She's now at University of Stanford over in California. So another of those historic women's teams over the decades of collegiate swimming in the women's and men's side. Gold medal then for China. Zhang Yufei upgrading the silver she won in the 100 finally to gold in the 200.
She trains at the Nanjing Sports Institute. And it was a beautiful swim to watch. Technically just so strong and almost flawless with her technique.
Under the world record pace in the early stages of that 200, she can measure her effort. Perhaps the overall time will edge closer to the world record.
Mesdames et messieurs, l'hymne de la République populaire de Chine. Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of the People's Republic of China.
And now the national anthem for the People's Republic of China. Olympic medalists in the women's 200 butterfly. Zhang on the top of the pile, the two Americans with the minor medals. Regan Smith and Harry Flickinger, second medal of these Tokyo 2020 Olympic Games for Flickinger, second bronze, 400 individual medley, 200 butterfly. We've seen that combination over the years. It's a tough event, add to the 800 freestyle to that, and you'll see the measure of the versatility of the swimmers who competed some of the toughest events around the programme. Swimmers being ushered off the rostrum now and paraded around. You've seen the drill by now. They go in front of the photographers on one side, parade around the pool, the photographers on the other side, enjoy their moment in the sun, and then off for the media interviews. Perhaps going for another swim down, refuel, physical manipulation. But before all of that, they've got to go into not just the mix zone under where we're sitting, but right around into the press conference area to face the media again.
What a great moment. Images will be sent right around the world of Zhang and her gold medal.
What does it take to get to the world record? Because it's a huge ask, perhaps an unfair question. Maybe the better question is, what does it take to progress one's personal best times in pursuit of well, in pursuit of ending the career, as giving everything to the sport, giving everything to the event, because you need speed. So do you concentrate on pure swimming speed, or do you spend your time working on that final 50 and the second 100
with endurance? It's everything, isn't it? It's the technical aspects of it as well, nailing all of those turns.
Oh, good.